back. Hello, hello, guys. Welcome back. Welcome back. How are you?
Hi, teacher. I'm fine, and you?
Very good. I'm sorry that I could not connect. I was finishing the other class. Everybody was very excited because today is the last day. Are you ready?
Yes, I
It's
think
your
we're ready.
last day. Are you ready?
Yes.
How do you feel?
Feel nervous.
Why do you feel nervous? It's your last day. You should feel excited. You should feel very excited.
Yeah, because I hope that I can. ¿Cómo era? Let me see, se me olvidó. I hope I could start the other el otro módulo.
Oh, you will. Do you have any questions about el otro módulo? Does anybody have any questions about documents, start dates, anything? Do you have any questions? Ask me. Don't be shy. Nobody has any questions? That's incredible.
Teacher, solo una consulta, tal vez fuera de lo que está mencionando, pero igual, fíjese de que no me recuerdo cuál es el pasado de tener.
Tener.
Ajá.
¿Qué, me puede dar una oración?
Quiero ver. Por lo menos el que tenemos en el examen,
¿Cuál
pero en
número?
el módulo, permítame, teacher, lo voy a para aclararle bien, creo que es el 4.9.
Okay.
Por Nay.
¿Cuál era la oración?
La oración decía que teníamos que ordenarlo en tiempo pasado.
Hágame un favor, tómele una foto y me la manda en WhatsApp directo.
Gracias, teacher.
Yo le ayudo. Okay. All right. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Today we're going to be looking at the final exam. The final exam. We're going to be looking at section C. Select the best answer. Select the best answer. Where your parents born in the US? ¿Nacieron tus padres en los Estados Unidos? Were your parents born in the US? Now, for the first activity, it says no. They weren't. My parents were born in Japan. So, right now, what we're going to do is we're going to look at the next activity. For the next activity is going to be section D. Match the verbs to the nouns. For example, number one. Had, had. So, photos, a picnic, tennis, a play, swimming. So, what do you say? Had a picnic. I had a picnic. Now you will have 5 minutes, 5 minutes to complete this activity. Any questions? Any questions?
No question.
let's work on the activity. You will have 5 minutes. 5 minutes. Ready, let's go.
Hi, everyone. Good evening.
Hi.
So we're going to do the D part. Vamos a hacer la parte D, ¿correcto?
Así es.
Okay. So, ¿ustedes ya lo hicieron o lo tenemos que hacer?
Ya lo tengo hecho, no sé, los demás.
¿Dir? No sé si me escucho.
Hello. Es la parte D, ¿verdad?
¿Sí?
Sí.
Sí, yo sí lo tengo hecho.
Ok.
No sé, la otra compañera.
Sí, ya está hecho.
Si quieren, lo que podemos hacer es practicar la pronunciación.
Sí, okay, está bien.
Ok, entonces empieza uno de ustedes, después va el siguiente, y así sucesivamente. Dicen los cinco con su respuesta y así vamos practicando.
Ok. Empiezo si gustan.
Ok. Dale.
One had a picnic, two played tennis, three took photos, four went swimming, five saw a play.
Can you repeat the fourth?
Went swimming.
I'm sorry, third. I'm sorry. Tercero.
Ah. Took photos.
Took.
Okay. Les right. Iba a preguntar, fíjense, porque sí tenía duda en ese. Took photos. Bye. Yeah, y yeah, photos, está bien.
Sí, sí, correcto.
Okay.
Now, Waldir.
Okay, boy. Hot. A picnic. Mm-hmm. Played. Excuse me. Tennis.
Mm-hmm.
Took.
Mm-hmm.
Photos. ¿Cómo?
Photos.
Okay.
Yeah.
When. Swimming.
Mm-hmm.
Swat. A play.
How a play.
Ah, play.
Yeah, don't worry about it. No se preocupe. Now my turn. Let me see. First, had a picnic. Two, played tennis. Three, took photos. Four, went swimming. And five, saw a play.
Okay.
Repetimos. Yeah, but now, por ahora, let's try to make sentences. Intentemos hacer oraciones. Ya está ahí prácticamente la mitad de la oración. Solo sería añadirle un sujeto y algo extra si quieren.
Vamos a ver. Ajá, vaya.
Dele, pues, dele.
I had a picnic. A ver, en the last weekend. No, estará bien.
Ahí sí tendría.
Had está en pasado, ¿verdad?
Sí, no, sí, todo está correcto. Ahorita solo lo que tengo duda, no sé muy bien, es si es in the last weekend o on the last weekend. Ahí se me quitó la onda. Ahorita investigamos.
Bye. Bueno, voy a seguir tratando de armar oraciones.
Dele. Es on the last weekend, I'm sorry.
On the last weekend. Entonces sería, yes. I had a picnic on the last weekend.
Correcto.
A ver. Ahí tendríamos que usar siempre el I.
¿El qué, perdón?
El pronombre I. O puedo
usar, porque usar lo que usted quiera.
To play tennis.
With me? Podría ser.
Sí, como le digo, como sujeto podría ocupar you, she, he, they, we, I.
Do anything last weekend. 2.1. Yes, they went hiking in the woods. 3. Did she get anything at the mall? 3B. No. She went shopping, but she didn't buy anything.
Vemos si quiere lo pasamos en el siguiente. Ah, pero es que es de leerlo.
Casi no lo escucho.
Sí, fíjense que yo tengo problemas. Creo que son los audífonos. Por eso no se escucha bien. Que les digo aquí, si quiere repasemos el último, leamos solo para practicarlo.
El F.
El D. Ah, sí, F.
Sí, ahorita estábamos en el E.
Sí, el E. Para practicarlo.
¿Cuál? ¿El home alone?
Sí.
¿O las preguntas? No. El home alone. Vaya, empiece usted si quiere.
Jerry Carson. 16 had a terrible weekend. His parents went to visit his aunt, but he stayed home. He got up early on Saturday and went downstairs to the basement to the laundry. He went back upstairs, but at the top of the stairs, the door was locked. He pushed on it, but it didn't open. He called to his neighbors, but they didn't hear him. Luckily, Jerry had good night to it. There were some extra groceries in the basement, and he had a place to sleep. He put some clothes from the laundry on the floor and sleep on them. His parents can come home. His parents came home Sunday morning and found Jerry in the basement. He called Jerry late Saturday night, but he didn't answer the phone, said his father. He came home right away. Were just happy he survived.
Vaya. Sigue con las preguntas.
No, si quieren.
Solo, vaya. Solo para... Vaya, ahora voy yo. Home alone. Jerry Carson, 16, had a terrible weekend. His parents went to visit his aunt, but they stayed home. He got up early on Saturday and went downstairs to the basement to the laundry. He went back upstairs, but at the top of the stair, the doors were locked. He pushed on it, but it didn't open. He called to his neighbors, but they didn't hear him. Lucille, Jerry had food to eat. There were some extra groceries in the basement, and he.
Well, if I say I live in El Salvador, no digo en dónde estoy viviendo, solo digo que estoy en El Salvador. Sí. I live on San Salvador, por ejemplo.
Ya está especificando dónde.
Correcto. Entonces, como usted dice, ellos vieron el partido. en una televisión. So I they saw a play on television.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Yo también he tenido muchos problemas con eso.
Pero usted sabe un montón. ¿Cómo le ha hecho? Cuénteme.
Solo prácticamente en YouTube. Así he pasado. Sí, me pongo a ver en YouTube cómo lo pronuncia pues gente nativa. Y de ahí voy sacando ideas, sacando ideas. Y también a veces he tratado como de hablar con gente nativa que es de allá. Muchas veces me corrigen bastante.
Bueno, práctica entonces, ¿verdad?
Sí, es pura práctica.
Vaya, voy a tratar de ver más videos de YouTube entonces. Hoy que vamos a terminar este módulo.
Algo que a mí me recomendaban era ver caricaturas, pero caricaturas en inglés.
Ah, yo trato de ver películas, pero la verdad, a veces me quedo así como que no les entendí nada. Ajá, eso, cuando no está subtitulada. Cuando está subtitulada, o sea, voy leyendo y sí siento que entiendo la pronunciación y lo que dicen, ¿verdad? Pero así ya solo que lo hablen, sí me cuesta bastante.
A mí por eso me dicen y me decían que intenté con caricaturas. Yo una vez pregunté por qué, no sé si esa era la verdadera razón o solo me quisieron dar esa explicación, de que lo que va dirigido en caricaturas, como va un poco más para niños, ellos no abrevian mucho las palabras y tratan de hablar más claro.
Pues tiene lógica lo que le dijeron. Pues voy a buscar entonces una caricatura en inglés.
Sí, porque a mí eso me ha ayudado. Ok, bueno, my turn. Sí.
Bueno, gracias.
You're welcome. Let me see. I had a picnic with my girlfriend yesterday. They played tennis in the morning. My mother took photos on my birthday. Voy a copiar ahí al compañero. I went to swimming on the last weekend. Y I saw a soccer play yesterday.
Sí, está bien. Está bien. Vaya, no me vaya a decir que me invente otras oraciones porque ya pensé un montón en esas. Pero sí está bueno, me gustó esta idea de formar oraciones.
Así se va ganando la práctica y la confianza para hablar el idioma.
Sí. Bueno. ¿Y por qué no vemos el siguiente? Aprovechando que...
Ok.
Aunque ya la mayor... Bueno, yo creo que ya todos lo hicimos, ¿verdad?
Yo ya lo terminé. Bueno, sí, creo que ya todos lo terminaron. Complete the conversations. Ok. So, si gusta, hicimos como hacemos como el pasado.
Los leemos. Vaya, vamos a ver. Did you have a good weekend? Not really. I started all weekend. And number two, did they do anything last weekend? Yes, they went hiking in the woods.
In
the woods. Three. Did she get anything out of the mall? No, she went shopping, but she didn't buy anything.
That's great. Estuvo bueno. Waldir, Do you want to try?
Okay, voy.
Okay.
Did you have a good weekend?
Mm-hmm.
No, really. I studied all weekend. Did they do anything last weekend? Yes. They went hiking, ¿cómo se pronuncia hiking? Hiking. Hiking. Yes. Hiking in the wolf.
Woods.
Hiking in the wood.
Woods. Try to pronounce the D and the S. Voy a pronunciar la D y la S. Ajá, correcto. Woods.
Good. Okay. Did she get anything on the mall?
Mm-hmm.
No, she went shopping.
She went shopping.
Mm-hmm. But she didn't buy anything.
Try to pronounce but.
But.
Correct. Yes.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Now it's my turn. Let me see.
All right. Now let's look at the first one. We're going to be looking at number two, played. Who can tell me the answer for the first one? Played. Photos, a picnic, tennis, a play, swimming.
Tennis.
Tennis. Played tennis. Number three, took. Took a picture. Took photos.
Photos.
Yes.
Correct. Went. Went.
Screen.
Went.
Screen.
Swimming.
Swimming. Went swimming. Saw.
Saw.
Excellent. Now, what we're going to do is move forward. At this moment, does anybody have any questions referring to this section?
Yes, teacher, I have a question.
What is your question?
What is the difference between photos and pictures?
Photos is like old, like in the past, like old people say photos. Nowadays, everybody says selfie, picture. Nobody says photos. That's from the past.
Okay, thank you.
All right. E, complete the conversation. Select the correct form of the verb. Select the correct form of the verb to complete the sentences. Number one, a good weekend. Did you had a good weekend? Did you have a good weekend? You had a good weekend. What is your answer?
Did you have a good weekend?
Correct. You will have 5 minutes to complete the activity. Ready? Let's go.
Sí, está bien. Okay. Lo voy a repetir entonces. Sí, lo voy a leer acá para así practicando tal vez. Select the correct for us the bear. Select the correct for us the bear to complete the sentence.
Complete.
One. Complete this sentence. One.
Okay.
Do you have a good weekend?
Weekend. Se me olvida. Sale la D al final.
Weekend.
Ahora la segunda.
Not really, a student, I weekend.
Study.
Ah, sí, perdón. Not really, I study, I
really. Really, Marisa. Really.
Really. Not really, I student, I weekend.
Study.
Study, hi.
All weekend.
Weekend.
All weekend. Acuérdese que le decía que si
para que lo así. Weekend. All solo weekend. Quitarle.
All weekend.
All weekend. La siguiente sería, did they do anything last weekend?
Anything.
Anything. Did they do anything?
Anything last weekend.
Okay. Siguiente. Next. Yes.
Que le suene la T, Marisa. Went.
Yes, they went.
Uh-huh.
Hid king in the wall.
Woods. Woods.
Woods.
In the woods.
Yes, they went hid kid in the woods.
Next.
Did she have anything at the May? My
mom.
Yes.
Mom. Did she mom. Have Did she
anything
get
at the mall?
At the mall.
More. Solo una L.
Lo que pasa es que como, va como que mall. O sea, la lengua como que tiene que quedar un poquito trabada.
Mall. Entonces sería, did she have anything at the mall?
Anything. Ajá,
último. Ahora la última, que es... No, she went shopping, but she didn't buy anything.
No, she went shopping, but she didn't buy anything. Anything. Volvamos a pronunciar otra vez.
Sí, está bien.
Yo lo voy a ir ayudando siempre, aunque sea un poquito, en lo que yo puedo.
Vale, está bien. Entonces, continúo, permítame. Empiezo nuevamente, entonces. Select the correct for us the verb to complement. This sentence.
No, complete. To complete.
Select the correct for us the verb. To complete.
The sentence.
One. Did you have a good
weekend?
Weekend.
Con D al final. Weekend.
Weekend. Did you have a good
weekend? Bye.
Next. No. Really? I student.
No.
Al
weekend. Study.
Not really. I studied all weekend.
All Marisa, all weekend.
Not really. I studying all study. Weekend.
Study, Marisa.
Study.
Study. All weekend.
Study all weekend.
All weekend. All.
All weekend.
Weekend.
Creo que haré una planadeza.
All y weekend.
prácticamente en todos los ejercicios que hemos tenido ahí me queda. Weekend.
No, poco a weekend. Poco, Marisa, no creo, no es fácil, a mí también me cuesta. But,
did they do anything last weekend? Anything last
weekend.
La siguiente. Yes. They went to kill in the world.
Good.
Esas son palabras. Good. Son palabras, ¿verdad?
Ajá. No, es como bosque, creo que es. Vamos a averiguar, creo que bosque significa.
Sí. Ajá.
¿Busca, tiene este traductor ahí?
Ahorita lo voy a...
¿Vemos? Ajá, búsquelo.
Maderas.
Good.
Maderas, ajá.
Bosque.
Good.
Ah, bosque. Next.
Siguiente. Did she have any teeth at the mall?
No, at the mall.
At the mall.
Ajá, mall.
Mall. Next. No, she went shopping, but she didn't buy anything.
Didn't buy anything. Un poquito, y ahí vamos mejorando.
Sí.
¿Lo hacemos de nuevo?
Sí, si gusta lo escucho ahora para...
Select the correct form of the verb to complete the sentence. Number one, did you have a good weekend? Next. Not really, I started.
All right. Let's check. Number one. Not really. I studied.
A, B, or C.
A.
Correct. Number two. Anything last weekend? What is your answer? Did they do anything last weekend is correct. Number two. Yes, they hiking in the woods. Went. Correct. Correct. Number three. Anything at the mall?
Did she get?
Very good. Did she get anything at the mall? No. She went shopping, but she
didn't buy.
Very good. Didn't buy anything. Excellent. Perfect. Read the article and complete the sentences. Let me have one volunteer read the first section. One volunteer read the first section.
Me, teacher.
Okay.
Jerry Carson, 16, had a terrible weekend. His parents went to visit his aunt, but he stayed at home. He got up early on Saturday and went downstairs to the basement to the laundry.
Very good. Select somebody.
Patty,
continue.
He went back upstairs, but on the top of the stair. The door was locked. He pushed on it, but it didn't open. He called to his neighbors, but they didn't hear him.
Stop. Felt like somebody.
Norma Rosales.
Norma Rosales, continue.
Yes. Little Jerry had food to eat. There were some extra groceries in the basement, and he had a place to sleep. He put some clothes from the laundry on the floor and slept on things.
Stop right there. Select somebody.
Marco Landaverde.
Marco, continue.
His parents came home Sunday morning and found Jerry in the basement. We called Jerry last Saturday night, but he didn't answer the phone, said his father. We came home right away. We are just happy he's all right.
Perfect. Okay. So now what I want you to do is I want you to work in pairs and practice the text. And then you are going to look at the first activity on the video. Can you see? Why did Jerry go to the basement? Where did Jerry sleep? You are going to answer the questions. You will have 5 minutes. Are you ready?
Yes.
Let's go.
C. siquiera como ya las tenemos, ¿verdad? Solo las repasamos.
Ay, ve, porque a mí lo que me cuesta es la pronunciación.
Ah, sí, pues sí.
Yo sí. Oigo que usted bastante bien.
No, para nada. El marco, sí, ¿verdad? Bien bonito.
Sí, bien bonito.
Sí.
Si gusta, entonces practicamos la pronunciación.
Ajá.
Comienzo.
Sí.
¿Ya lo tiene usted?
Sí.
Va. We did Jerry go to the basement. To do laundry. Where did Jerry sleep? Jerry sleep on the floor. Uy, yes. Permítame, si no lo veo esta otra, ya. With the Jerry parents, ¿cómo se sería esa palabra? La que sigue, the parents.
Ah, return.
Return.
Oh, return.
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 We did Jerry Parent return home Sunday morning because Jerry didn't answer the phone when his parents called to check on him.
Para saber de él.
¿Perdón?
Ajá, sí, así, ellos le llamaban para saber de él, dice.
Sí.
Bueno. Why did Jerry go to the basement? To the laundry. Where did Jerry sleep? Jerry sleep on the floor. Why did Jerry's parents return home Sunday morning? Ah. Because Jerry didn't answer the phone when his parents called to check on him.
Okay. Will did Jerry go to the basement to do laundry? Where did Jerry sleep? Yes, Jerry sleep on the floor. With Jerry's parents...
Norma,
perdón, dígame.
Why?
Perdón, why?
Porque,
why did?
Why
did Jerry's parents, gracias. Why did Jerry's parents return home Sunday morning? Because Jerry didn't answer the phone when his parents called to check on him.
Why did Jerry go to the basement? To the laundry. To the laundry. To the laundry. Where did Jerry sleep? Jerry sleep on the floor. Why did Jerry's parents return home Sunday morning? Because Jerry didn't answer the phone when his parents called to check on him. Es que esa es la diferencia, mi. Why y because es por qué y por qué. Why es pregunta, ¿por qué? Y because es, porque es... Jerry no contestó el teléfono cuando sus papás lo llamaron para saber de él.
Gracias.
Son los dos por qué.
Ajá, eso es lo que estaba preguntando ahora el otro compañero, ¿verdad? Que cuál era la diferencia en las otras palabras. Relativamente vendría a ser esa, ¿verdad?
Sí, son siempre porque, son por qué las dos, pero una es pregunta y la otra es...
Es como una respuesta, o digamos que se está hablando así de forma natural.
Ajá,
digamos, ¿por qué no fui a la casa o porque llegué tarde, divierta? Pero que no es pregunta.
Sí, no es pregunta.
Why did Jerry go to the basement to the laundry?
Where did Jerry sleep? Jerry sleep on the floor. Why did Jerry's parents return home Sunday morning? Because Jerry didn't answer the phone when his parents called to check on him.
Y esta es la última, ¿verdad?
Yo creo que sí, ya casi sí, van a ser sí. Las 10.
Llevo 5 minutos, creo que solo se va a despedir. No, como ya la leyeron.
Uh-huh. Sí, sí, la verdad es que ya era poquito lo de ahora.
Sí, solo 2, ¿verdad? O 3, no, como 3 minutos.
Sí, porque... Uh-huh. Como ya la mayoría, gracias a Dios, ya lo habíamos hecho.
Sí, bueno, a ver si continuamos.
Primero Dios que nos den la oportunidad sí. Para el siguiente.
Sí, y ya le respondieron a usted.
Fíjese que no. No, ahorita...
all right, let me have... one volunteer for number one.
To do laundry.
Number two.
Where did Jerry sleep?
Mm-hmm.
Jerry sleep on the floor.
Oh, Jerry slept on the floor. Number three. One volunteer. Number three.
Because Jerry didn't answer the phone when his parents called to check on him.
Ding, ding, ding. Correct. That is correct. Any questions? Any questions?
No.
All right. Now I want you to write 5 questions. WH questions. What, where, when, how, why, who, whose, whom. I will repeat. You will write questions with what, where, when, who, whose, whom. 5 questions in pairs. You have 3 minutes. 3 minutes.
Perdón, ay Roxana, perdón, tenía desactivado el audio, yo juraba que estaba hablando. Le preguntaba, que le decía que yo no entendí qué es lo que íbamos a hacer.
Ah, 5 preguntas utilizando when, who, how, where, why.
Yeah.
Pero eso es de lo que hemos estado haciendo.
De las que hemos estado haciendo.
Uh-huh. Pero ya terminó el tiempo. Ah, bueno, a veces me dejo. Por ejemplo, why did you go to the beach? ¿Por qué fuiste a la playa? No, ustedes, no, chicos. ¿Es donde? Ah, puede ser.
También, bueno, yo estaba formulando, why did you go, ¿por qué saliste?
¿Sí?
Why did you go?
Y un ejemplo que estaba viendo yo, que él preguntó la vez anterior, bueno, ahí estaba en el ejercicio, who was your favorite teacher? ¿Qué sería? ¿Cuál es tu, quién fue tu profesor favorito?
Ah.
Le podemos cambiar nada más. Yo le he puesto, who was your favorite movie?
Sí.
Eso es como... Ay, no, pero es who. Es quién.
Uh-huh.
Friends. No, sí, bueno. Friends. ¿Quién fue tu amigo favorito?
¿Quién es su amigo favorito?
Uh-huh. ¿Quién fue? Porque was. O puede ser who is your favorite friends. Uh-huh.
También.
¿Quién es? Uh-huh.
Con where podría ser como. Como ahí es ver este. Usarle las palabras de pregunta, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh. ¿Dónde?
Where did you put the blouse? ¿Dónde pusiste la blusa? Where did you put the blouse?
Sí, ¿en dónde?
Where did you put the blues? P-U-T.
All right, everybody. Time's up. Time's up. Let me have one volunteer.
Me, teacher.
All right, Roxana, ask me a question.
Why did you go to the beach?
Because I love the beach. Roxana, ask Maria a question.
Why did you go to the beach, Maria?
Okay.
Perdón, tenía apagado el micrófono.
That's okay.
¿Me repite la pregunta, por favor?
Repeat the question, please.
Why did you go to the beach, Maria?
¿Cuándo fue a la playa?
That's right. Yes.
Yes, why?
I don't remember.
You say, I love the beach.
Ah, okay. You say, I love the
beach. Because I love.
Because I love the beach. All right, guys. Bye-bye. That's it. See See you next week. Good night. Enjoy. Thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you.
Yes.
Teacher. When start the other level?
Tuesday.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. If you have any questions, write me and I will be right here. Good night. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Good night.
Thank you. Bye. Bye-bye. Thank you.